morning and welcome back to Questioning Scents with me, Matt. How are you doing? I hope you're well. As I mentioned in the recent video, under lockdown yet again, but you know, as I said before, not really making that much difference to the Questioning Scents household as we are. You know, I'm working, my wife's working, my son's at school, so just the fun stuff we're not doing. I love going out to eat and I love going to the pub, and I'm not going to be doing any of them. So I'm looking forward to all that reopening and cracking on. But one thing the lockdown hasn't interfered with is perfume. Well, it has actually. It has interfered a little because there's quite a few that I really want to go out and smell at the moment, and I can't get in a store, which is really annoying. I'm really looking forward to getting into Jovoy soon, because there's a couple of things that I've discovered or I've been told about that I really need to sniff. So hopefully I'll get in there as soon as possible, get some samples or even maybe a buy to, you know, explore these wonderful perfumes that I've been told about. Anyway, talking of exploring wonderful perfumes, a little while ago I was talking to a company in Leicester in England called Aroma Concepts. Now, we'll put a link up to their site. They're an independent perfume house, which is great. You know, I love these smaller perfume businesses or perfume shops, if you want, online stores. But I mean, I think this is an online store. I'm not sure if there's a physical shop as well. But they are one of the few in the UK that import and deal with Arabian perfume. So that's always good, because these perfumes can be quite difficult to get hold of. You know, I remember I've had to trawl eBay, I've had to buy perfumes in Kuwait and have them delivered over here. So it's always good to have, you know, one on, not on your doorstep, I admit that. I live in London and they're in Leicester, which is quite a way away. But, you know, to have a UK-based company that can deliver the Middle Eastern perfumes that I really, really enjoy is always a good thing. So anyway, I was speaking to these guys. There's one particular perfume I was after, which they had in stock. So we spoke a bit about that. And then, you know, they found out that I've got this channel. And obviously, you know, I now follow them on Instagram. They follow me. And, you know, they've seen some of my videos. So in the conversation, they said, very kindly, would you mind if we sent you some perfumes for your, you know, no pressure to review them, just to see what you think. So I said, okay, fair enough. And they sent me three. Now, obviously, this is the bit where everyone says, I haven't bought these perfumes, so all the blah, 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 opinions, etc., etc. Well, look, I'm only going to review one of them today. They did send me three, so we'll have a brief look at all three of them, and then there'll be reviews of them coming. And I can say that, yes, my opinions, I haven't been swayed by receiving some free bottles. We're not quite that shallow here. And the other thing is, if I was sent perfume, we're not a channel that gets sent hundreds of bottles, don't get me wrong. You know, the odd one does come our way, and quite a few samples come our way. And generally speaking, if I don't like the perfume or I don't think it's worth it, I won't review it. So, you know, you can take that as it is, because, you know, the whole point of Questioning Scents is to talk about perfumes that Rich and I actually wear. And I'm certainly going to be wearing these. So there you go. The first one that I looked at is this one. It's called Infini. And it's by a company called Cadlage, I think they pronounce it. I don't really know much about this one. I've only sprayed it a little bit on skin, and I haven't worn it properly yet, so I'm not really going to talk too much about it. My initial impressions are it smells a little bit like a cross between Sauvage and Aventus, but let me wear it and then I'll come back to you with a full review of it. They're all very affordable as well. So the other one they sent me is this one, and it's by a company called Ministry of Oud. Now, Ministry of Oud, as I understand, there's a few companies that come under the banner of Paris Corner, and I believe it's from them. But the bottle on this is superb. It's beautiful. It's called Greatest, and it's Ministry of Oud's interpretation of, you've guessed it, Oud for Greatness from Initio. Now, I do also have already had this one, which is that Badi Al Oud or Oud for Glory. The guys at Aroma sell both, but they think this one's better than this one. Now, I have worn this one and I've worn it to work. So what I'm going to do is, I'm not going to try and cram too much in. I will film as soon as I can a full comparison between the two, because obviously there's a lot of hype about this one. And I think this one may be able to take the throne away from it. So let me spend a little bit more time with it and then I'll come back with a video where I compare the two. Rich has actually sent me a very large decant of the original. So what I'm going to do is wear the original and wear the Latafa one and wear the original and wear the Ministry of Oud one, so I can get a real comparison, and then we can do a note breakdown and look into it in a little bit more depth. But the one they sent that I'm going to talk about today is this one. It's called Charuto Tobacco Vanille by Pendora Scents. Now, this is another banner that comes under the Paris Corner label. So if you have a look at that, the bottle's all right. It's like frosted glass. Very, very tight-fitting cap. Spray is pretty good. Excellent sprayer, actually. I'm not too keen on this bit. This is kind of not great. I mean, it works, don't get me wrong. But the bottle's all right. It's not the most stunning bottle, but it's okay. It actually sells for 25 quid. So that's, I think, an excellent price. Now, with a name like Charuto Tobacco Vanille, you know what this is going to be smelling like. And it is indeed a clone of Tom Ford's Tobacco Vanille. Now, I'm not going to get into the whole clone debate again, because every time I talk about clone, I seem to get drawn into it. This costs 25 quid, and I think, 50 mil from the Tom Ford is like £150 or something like that. So, you know, they're miles apart in terms of cost. And if someone was to buy this, would it be taking a sale away from Tom Ford? No, of course it wouldn't. This is 25 quid. You know, there's a massive difference between £25 and £160. If you're prepared to spend £160 on a 50 mil perfume, you're going to spend it. If your budget allows you to spend £25, you're going to buy this. The two are not comparable, in my opinion. So there you have it. Now, Tobacco Vanille is an interesting fragrance to me. Outside of a couple of the Maison Francis Curtejans, Tobacco Vanille is the fragrance that I have probably bought decants of more than any other fragrance, because I really like it, but I don't love it enough to chuck that much money at a bottle. If a bottle of Tobacco Vanille came up in one of the groups at a good price, then I'd probably get it. But it's one I like, it's not one I love, I'll be honest with you. I like Tobacco Vanille, but I don't crave it, I don't love it. Sometimes, you know, it's really good to wear, and, you know, I've got through quite a lot of decants of it, so obviously you do know that I have worn it a fair bit. But also, I have got quite a few fragrances that are in that world, so to spend so much money on something like that, when I've got four or five, maybe even six perfumes that do the same kind of thing, although they are all different, it just doesn't seem worth it to me. I'd rather put that, you know, big money into something else that I haven't got, or something that's a bit more unique to my collection. So let's have a look at this. I don't know how long this has been on the market. I think it's been around a while. I mean, Aroma Concepts themselves have been in business for about a year, I think. And as I say, we'll put a link up to their site. So they've got a lot of interesting perfumes, but let's focus on this one. So if we look at the notes, on the top you have tobacco leaf and spices, and then in the middle you have tonka bean, tobacco flower, vanilla, and cocoa. And then on the base, you have a dry fruit accord and woods. So there you have it. Instantly, you know what you're going to get. It smells like Tobacco Vanille, but it smells like a lighter version of it. Now, Tobacco Vanille, one of the reasons that I don't love it as much as some people, when I wear Tobacco Vanille, the original Tom Ford, it smells divine, but I started associating it with, because of the spices in it, it does smell a bit like a Christmas cake, and I quite like that because it's a bit gourmandy, and I quite like that sort of old cakey vibe. It's really good for the forthcoming festive season. But then it started reminding me a bit of a Yankee candle, and my wife pointed out, that smells like one of those candles. You know, smells like I'm walking past one of those like sort of lush shops or something like that, where you've got all these really strong smells coming out. And that did kind of knock me off my equilibrium with the fragrance a bit. So it kind of put me off. I've still got a little bit left somewhere. I mean, the fact I don't know where it is will show you just how important it is to me. And I did start thinking every time I'm smelling a bit like a Yankee candle. So that has kind of put me off. Now, what this one does is it simulates Tobacco Vanille very, very well. As soon as you smell it, you know, I just sprayed it there. I wore it this morning. I wore it on the school run. You get a lighter version of Tobacco Vanille. So everything that's in Tobacco Vanille is in here, but it's a little bit, and dare I say it, and this is probably gonna ruffle a few feathers, it's actually a bit more wearable. And because it's kind of like a lighter version, it's less cloying, it's less intense. And Tobacco Vanille, the original, is one that you tend to wear very much on a cold day and stuff like that. And I've worn this quite a few times now. As you can see, there's quite a lot come out of it. So I have been really, really road testing it. And I've worn it on days where I thought were going to be cold, and when I've gone out, it's actually turned out to be quite warm, and it's performed really well, and it smells great. Now, performance is a strange one with this one. I'll give it that. When I first got it, I decided to sample it in the evening. Now, you know, those of you that know me will know, when I come back from work, I normally wear a big scent for work, and then when I come home, I generally have a nice relaxing soak in the bath in the evening. I'm quite old fashioned like that. And when I get out of the bath, I do a few different things. I either wear some oud, I either wear a fragrance that I, you know, love, that comforts me if I'm particularly stressed out or anything like that, or I use my evenings to try new fragrances. So I tried this in an evening after work. And sometimes when I have my bath stupidly hot, so the bathroom fills with steam, it turns into a bit like a sauna. And that can, when you're breathing in steam, it can kind of have a cloud my sense of smell a bit. So I got out and I absolutely went berserk with this. I put it everywhere. I sprayed it all over with about 12 sprays, really heavy. And thought, oh, it smells the bollocks. Then I came out of the bathroom. And my wife was like, what the hell have you done? What is that? That is so, so strong. And I didn't realise just how loud this is in the beginning. It really, really does belt out. So I thought, oh, great, you know, this is going to be proper beast mode. Like the old tobacco vanille, I've noticed that when I get decants of it, it seems to vary in strength. Now, I think when it was first launched, tobacco vanille was a really potent fragrance. And I think, like a lot of fragrance, it's kind of mellowed out a bit over time and possibly been some reformulations. I'm not entirely sure. But the last few decants I had of it haven't been as potent. So when I first sprayed that, I thought, excellent, this is super, super potent. This is going to be massive. And it's not. It just opens really, really loudly. You get this big blast, this sort of strong tobacco, this creamy, rich, slightly sweet vanilla, and these wonderful spices that come up before you get to the woody part. Now, when this, as I say, for the first 10 minutes, this really belts out, it's everywhere. You are definitely thinking, uh-oh, proper beast mode. Then it drops off quite quickly after that. So you get kind of like about half an hour of a massive opening, and then it sits above your skin. Now, I thought that it didn't project pretty well. So I was wearing it to work and thought, yeah, this is good. I can smell it all day, you know, for a whole shift. So I'm out for 7 or 8 hours, I can smell it the entire time. But I thought the projection had dried off. Now, when I last wore this to work, I popped into an office that I go into now and again and was chatting to one of my colleagues, who's a bit of a fraghead, who announced that he could smell me really well and he really liked what I was wearing. Now, that was probably 4 or 5 hours after I've applied it. So if it's still projecting, although I think quite modestly, I mean, the office was quite small, it was still projecting 4 or 5 hours in. So I think the performance is pretty, pretty good. Well worth it. I mean, for 25 quid as well, that's an excellent price. If you are looking for an alternative to Tom Ford's Tobacco Vanille, this is a pretty good one, actually. It's I'd say it's one of the better ones that I've tried. I prefer it to the Perfume Parlour one, and that's the only one I've actually got around the house at the moment. So I think it's a better option than the Perfume Parlour one. So there you have it, really. This is a bargain version of Tom Ford's Tobacco Vanille. It's not, you know, the bottle's not as good looking and all the rest of it, but it's 25 quid. So, you know, well worth exploring. Now, the other thing I wanted to mention is Tobacco Vanille, I think, is probably the most unisex perfume out there. It's just, it smells amazing on a woman and it smells amazing on a man. So, you know, perfect for that. It's ageless. I think it's, as a fragrance, it's probably suited more to the more mature enthusiast, although I'm sure some of the thrusters out there will enjoy wearing it. You know, it's the festive season coming and this would be perfect for it, basically. So there you have it. Well worth having a look. Have a look at Aroma, though, because they've got, if you look on Aroma Concepts website, they've got lots and lots of different perfumes that are well worth exploring. So what I will do, as promised, is I will come back with a comparison between these two, because they're similarly priced as well. There's not a lot of difference in cost. At the moment, though, without really wearing them side by side, I'm edging towards this one. But this one's still pretty good, you know. And the other thing is, I'm not a massive fan of the original, so, you know, I can give a much more sort of what's the word I'm looking for? A less passionate argument for buying the original, because I'm not that fussed by it. But both of these are pretty good. Anyway, I'll get that put into the works, and we will come back to you as soon as possible with the other review. Anyway, listen, guys, thank you very much for your time. It's always a pleasure. I hope you've enjoyed the review, and I will speak to you guys soon. Take care, cheers, and bye.